the Blinks program, which is a undergraduate research program. And because of their funding, I was able to travel to Friday Harbor Laboratories on the San Juan Islands in Washington State. What I wanted to do is I wanted to study the chemical signaling between the bubble snail, which was the prey, and purple shore crabs and hermit crabs, which were the predators. I exposed the bubble snails to water that the crabs had been in, and I wanted to see if they respond somehow by defending their offspring chemically.
This research experience kind of opened a new world that you don't really see in your in a classroom setting. For my project, I wanted to find out if these sea slugs that I worked with, they lay their embryos in very large clutches or egg masses. They anchor them to the sand, and I wanted to see if they would anchor their egg masses more strongly under higher flow rates.
What's interesting about this is that this suggests that for any given mass weight, you have a significant influence of population on the size of the tether weight.
The timing of it was great. Halfway through my college career, I got to do something really hands-on, saw some of the applications of what I studied in the classroom.
Here we have all the crabs that are going to be fed the treatments from below, the egg masses from the treatments from below. And I've got it set up so there's alternating between purple shore crabs and hermit crabs. I've got the plexiglass so I can see what they're doing if they've escaped, and I've got flow distributed throughout the tank so that they'll get some even water circulation.
We knew that one of the predators was more dangerous to the egg masses than the other one. We predicted that hermit crabs would be more deterred by the chemical defense than the shore crabs, and that turned out not to be the case, which was a surprising result. And a lot of times people think, you know, if you don't get the prediction that you're expecting to get, that that's a failure. But in reality, it never is, because you always have more knowledge than you had before.
It really encouraged me to really start looking into graduate schools. I hope to work on this project more. I'm continuing work with my mentor, Dr. Podolsky, in the lab. I'm hoping to get my project published in a paper. I can take this project to biological meetings, hopefully get this presented. It's really exciting world we got introduced to this summer.